rain in the area, but we've been given the go-ahead to get this one started.
Ought to be a good one here between the Oakland A's and the Tampa Bay Rays. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Ready now is Josh Harrison. He will lead this one off today. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss of ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
Striding in for Oakland, Starling Marte. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit on the ground out to short, right to him. And that's the second out. Bases are empty here with two away. And that brings in the big power hitting first baseman, Matt Olson. Here's a foul ball left side, and that'll move it to 1-2. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Lifted in the air out to left, and that gets down, and we'll see if that's extra bases. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
That is cool. The left fielder, number 20.
In now, Mark Canna, and the count will be full.
Hey, that's a good sinker right there. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's got that going, especially early, it's going to be tough to get some runs off him.
High in the air down the right field line, and it's a foul ball. Now he extends nicely, and this ball's driven to right field and deep. Going back is the right fielder, and that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. To the plate now, Seth Brown. And it's fouled away.
I'm shocked he was even able to foul that one away. Now he's got to set his sights back over the heart of the plate and maybe be ready for something inside.
Here he comes again, 1-2. That's lifted the other way out to left. And Meadows makes the catch for out number 3. And now, Brandon Lau. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Still 1-2. Got him. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Wander Franco, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And this isn't his strong side, at least not in terms when you look at the stat sheet or his consistent contact rates. I just don't think he's quite as smooth with his rhythm and swing mechanics when he's hitting left-handed.
Too high, ball 3.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
The payoff pitch one more time. To short. Throw gets him, two down. And stepping in, G-Man Choi. Lifetime against this particular arm. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in 2 at-bats. And he fouls this one off. Payoff pitch one more time. Is swung on and missed, he got him. New inning set to get underway and set to go as the third baseman, Matt Chapman.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood inning. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now. Chris Davis will be next. The shift will be of little importance here as this is lifted in the air out to left field. Meadows comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number one. Now the A's designated hitter, Chris Davis. Davis waits on the 1-1. A little chopper up the middle, and he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
The second base.
Into the box now, Tony Kemp. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Lifted the other way to left center. Meadows is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So it's a runner at first with two gone, and that'll bring up Sean Murphy. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
One pitch shy of 40 for him right now, and he's not even out of the second inning of work. He's definitely not being as efficient on the mound as he'd like.
All even now, 2-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Nelson Cruz. The 1-1.
Great job of running that fastball in on his hands right there with two strikes. Even though the batter's able to foul that one off, he's set up for almost anything in this pitcher's arsenal.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down.
No left fielder. Off day. Better.
Swing and a miss, strike two.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Full count now, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he misses, ball four.
That is good. The right fielder, Randy.
Pops this one up. And there are two away now. Two down with a runner at first. And digging in next will be Joey Wendell.
Joey Wendell.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. Oh, and he can't come up with it. Into the box, Mike Zunino. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Top of the third set to get underway, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Josh Harrison. Swing and a liner. And a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning. So now to the plate, Starling Marte. 3-2 to the A's center fielder. That misses. So a single and a walk, and it's first and second with nobody out. Next up for the A's, Matt Olson. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at bat. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Harrison over at second. Marte at first with no outs. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. The next 1-2 pitch. Him out. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Mark Canna. And we'll see what he can do here after going deep his first time up.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
Full count now. Runners are at first and second with one away. And this is a strike three call. Oh, caught a break there. Two away.
Now that.
Next to dig in, Seth Brown. Two on, two out for him here in the third. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Hard hit ball to short. And there's a base hit as that gets through into left. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. Standing in now, Matt Chapman. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
3-1 here. You have to make a good amount. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
Here's the 3-2. And another foul ball. And he rolls over this one foul. We'll do it once more. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. And he struck him out. So he was forced to make 9 pitches that at bat, but he'll take it as the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Here's a fly ball, well hit, racing back, the right fielder still going back, gone into the home bullpen for a home run. Stepping in now, Brandon Lau. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Number 5, shortstop, Wonder.
And this will be fouled away. Hard sinker misses, 2-2.
Two ball, two strike.
Goes after the sinker there as this is fouled away. Here's another 2-2. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out.
Now batting.
So two are gone here in the Tampa Bay third inning. And that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. The 1-1.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up the big time power bat of right-handed hitter Chris Davis. Fooled pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul. And he chased it in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Davis is retired, and there's one away.
Now batter.
So bases are empty with one gone. And striding toward the plate to hit next, Tony Kemp. Hit out toward second. Fielded cleanly. In time to first, and there are two away. Now at the plate, Sean Murphy looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Hit back up the middle. Throw not in time, but boy, was that a remarkable effort just to get to that thing. At the plate now, Josh Harrison. And, ooh, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now. Really starting to pour now, and the forecast is not showing any signs of a break in the weather.
You know, one of the big issues is player safety, and right now this field is getting sloppy wet, man, and I don't know how much more rain this field can take.
So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two out double. At the plate, Starling Marte, and a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte.
He really needs to find a pitch to put this guy away with right here, right now. He can't allow this inning to get any worse than it's already become.
He's set. The 3-2. Swing and a liner. But pulled in at the hot corner, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And striding forward, the designated hitter, Nelson Cruz. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
And you know, the heavy stuff has finally arrived. This has got to be the hardest rain we've seen all afternoon.
The count now at 2-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Popped him up. Chapman moving to his left. One out. Now to the plate here is Austin Meadows. Worked a walk in his first plate appearance. The 1-1 home. Bouncer to the left side. And there's out number two. Here's Randy Arozarena. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. 1-1 is a cutter that misses 2-1.
After watching that one go by and a ball being called, you could rest assured he knows he's not getting away with another one of those. I guarantee you he's going to be aggressive on this next pitch.
This is line to left. That's his first base hit, making one for two now. So we'll go a little deeper into the bottom of the fourth as that extends the inning.
Now batting, the third baseman.
To the plate now, Joey Wendell. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball.
That's where he wants that sinker to end up, but that was a nice job of laying off.
Hit in the air to straightaway center. Marte is under it, and that will end the inning. Josh Fleming, a 6'2" left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that brings in the big power hitting first baseman Matt Olson. A 1-2.
Now this guy's a grinder, fouls off good pitches, and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Just hung in there on that one.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. High and deep down the left field line. And foul. Swing and a looper to left. Wendell ranging into the outfield. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down. So now it's Mark Canna. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Ready on 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here it comes.
3-2.
Three runs, 7 hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. He loses him on ball four. Next, it'll be Seth Brown, delivered an RBI single last time up. A 1-1. Takes a pitch for strike number two.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The 2-2. Jammed him there as this is rolled out to short. There's one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Struck him out, so he's down on strikes for the second time this afternoon.
Up next from Tampa.
So here's Kevin Kiermaier, and he blasted a homer in his first at bat. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Into the windup and the pitch. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
Up next for Tampa Bay.
Up next for the Rays, Brandon Lau trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. 2-1 to the Rays leadoff batter.
couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
3-1 our score as we play inning number 5.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. All set for the start of the inning, and up next, the power-hitting third baseman, Matt Chapman. This one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2. This is foul right side. Again, he sends it out of play. The next 3-2. Hit sharply on the ground. Scooped up. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Now bat.
Chris Davis next to bat. A hit in 2 tries so far. The 1-1 home.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
All even at 2-2. Here it is. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. Stepping in next, Tony Kemp, 0-for-2 with a fly ball and a ground out on his line to this point. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number 3. Bottom of the 6th inning now, and next will be the first year shortstop, Wander Franco. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. The 1-2. Grounded weakly toward third. Chapman's got it, and there's one down now. G-Man Choi the next to hit. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. 1-2, here it comes.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
2-2. A swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Going back is the right fielder. Gone! James Caprillion, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. So now to the plate, Nelson Cruz.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are 2 gone. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike 2. Hit in the air to right center field. This ball is carrying well. Back it goes, and it is out of here. Into the box now, Randy Arozarena. Swing and a blooper down the right field line. Olson ranging into the outfield. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. In at the plate is Sean Murphy, and he'll get us started in what's officially the back third of this one.
hit high and deep to right center. Kiermaier giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the first down. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Josh Harrison. He's 2 for 3 and looking for more here. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Sinker misses that time and it's 2-1. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Runners off for second. One ball and two strikes to count. Here comes the 1-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And that brings in the big power hitting first baseman Matt Olson. And this will be fouled away. Here now the 2-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Good battle. Count remains full. And he misses with it. Ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now. Big spot here. First and second. Two men gone. And striding in to bat next, it will be Mark Canna. Here's a topper fouled off to the right, and that'll even the count at 2-2. 2-2, here it is.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And that misses for ball four, so the potential go-ahead run moves over to third now. Seth Brown will be the first one to greet him, and he'll bat in a big spot here. Bases loaded and two out in the inning. Here's the 1-1. Took him right up the ladder that time. It's 1-2.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout score at 2-3, and the inning is over. So now to the plate, Joey Wendell. He flew out in his last AB. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Here comes the 1-2. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2. Staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Another 2-2 offering.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Lifted down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The next 3-2. Lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Striding in is Mike Zunino. 0-for-2 for him to this point. Trying to get that go-ahead run to scoring position now as he puts this one down. There's Harrison for one. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Wing and he puts a charge into this one high and deep, and you can't forget about it. This ball is gone. Jake Diekman takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs of this seventh frame.
Into the box, Brandon Lau. Now a slider down the middle, but laid off.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
And he'll strike out here yet again. As it's been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts. Into the corner and slicing foul. Lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't
figure. Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Ready to begin the eighth. And digging in as the big time power threat, Matt Chapman. The 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number two.
Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
Again, another foul ball. Another 1-2. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Here's Chris Davis now. McHugh into his motion, coming home with the 1-1 pitch. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball, you could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now. Andrew Kittredge enters the ball game out of the pen, looking for the final out here in the top of inning number eight. So now here is Tony Kemp. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Taken, strike two called, and it's even at 2-2.
I know closers are known for having the nastiest stuff on the team. Exploding fastballs, devastating off speed. But they'd be lying if they didn't say they wanted a two-run, three-run lead. That's exactly what this guy has a chance to do. Hand it to that monster in the ninth with a two-run lead.
At the plate now, Sean Murphy. On, he pops it up, and no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Bottom of inning number eight set to go, and next the dangerous power threat, G-Man Choi. Two balls and a strike to the Rays first baseman.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Following next is Nelson Cruz. He waits on deck. Right side, but it's well foul. Now the 3-2 pitch. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. A 1-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Brown has to come in from the next area code to put this one away.
Wow.
So now into the box is Austin Meadows. He's one for two in this one.
That last AB, when he hit the home run, that was a decent changeup. It was down in the zone, but one of the problems when you have a good changeup like this pitcher does, hitters go up there and they kind of look for that changeup. So he's going to have to locate it a little bit better in this upcoming at bat.
At the ball.
Inside and a hair low. It's two balls and two strikes.
That's the heavy sinker right there. He has the ability to get ground balls when he needs them.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Peter Fairbanks comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Peter
And that'll bring up Josh Harrison. So far, 2 for 3 in this one.
Yeah, it's always a nightmare taking on another team's closer trying to get back into a game, especially in the ninth inning. But having your leadoff guy up to start that inning is as good as you could have hoped for. So let's see if he can get something started here.
Harrison in front, 3 balls and a strike.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, 3 balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
Full count now, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. There's a well-hit ball out to right center field. Heading for second is Harrison. And he is in the second base with a double, his third hit this afternoon. Standing in now, Starling Marte. 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. Hit on the ground is short. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Next to hit, Matt Olson. His career numbers against this pitcher, not a big sample size, 0-for-1. A 1-1 home.
2-1, 1-3.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Swung on and missed, and it's even at 2-2.
Now this guy's got some of the nastiest stuff in the game, and it is absolutely no fun for an offense to try and piece together any type of attack when he's throwing this stuff.
Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside. Mark Canha is on deck. Lofted in the air out toward right center. And he can't track it down. A base hit. The runner from second crosses the plate. It's now a 5-4 ball game. At the plate, Mark Canha. High in the air out to center field. Kiermaier will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two. David Robertson gets the call here as he'll try and look for one out to finish this thing off. Seth Brown will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Crowd in excess of 37,000 come to their feet. In the dirt. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And not what they were hoping for as that moves the possible tying run into scoring position. Last strike now for Oakland. And he'll find a way to get a piece of that one to stay alive. Here's the 2-2.
That's a classic piece of pitching right there. You have to back hitters away from the plate to make them a little bit uncomfortable. Now you can go inside or outside.
Struck him out, so he'll strand the possible tying run at second, and a great job of working out of trouble as this ball game is over. A one-run finish today, 5-4 the final score. The Tampa Bay Rays get the win on the heels of 4 home runs. Colin McHugh pitches well enough to get the W. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
the final line score for this afternoon's ball game. For the victorious.